great in Game 7.
And this was the first Game 7.
That's, yes. Yeah.
On his resume, yeah. on his NHL resume. Right. So he gets the W. And, hey, Ben Bishop had done this a couple times, and he had showed up big in the past in Game 7s. And he did show up big this time. Look, most saves in a playoff game in Stars history. He's number 3 on the list to Turco and Belfour. And 52 stops was not enough.
I'm going to add to that. When I was there in that 53 save in 99, that was triple overtime. So, Ben, you need to play a little longer in that one.
He would have made it.
Ben Bishop was incredible in this game.
Yeah.
The reason that we went to double overtime watching this game was because of Ben Bishop and the saves that he was able to make. Absolutely outstanding effort.
No question. Ben Bishop, I mean, for him, these are the moments that you live for. And this body of work all game long. I mean, he made the timely save. He made the big save. They're outshot 18-1 in the second period, where he was called upon to just give his team a chance. And a lot of times, guys, you'll hear guys when you're in the net, some of the guys will skate by, they'll tap you. Hey, just give us a chance. Just keep us in there. Give us a chance so we get our legs, so we can find our game. And he did that and then some. This was one of the best performances of his career. He's a Vezina Trophy finalist this year, and with good merit to be so. Fifth all-time, courtesy of Elias Sports Bureau, fifth all-time in terms of most saves in a game in Game 7s in NHL history. That's a Jordan-like performance for Ben Bishop in front of family and friends in St. Louis.
Yeah, absolutely remarkable. I mean, I'm sure, Weeks, you played the position. You got to get frustrated sometimes saying, guys, give me the stick. I'll go, just give me one shot. Please, guys, just get one. Just get one. You go 4.5 periods, just under 4.5 periods, and your team gets one goal and you allow two. I mean, your goals against, he comes into Game 7s with two shutouts in his other two Game 7s, and he allows two goals in over four periods?
Yeah.
That's a remarkable performance in clutch situation by Ben Bishop. He was shelled constantly tonight.
Let this sink in. Second and third period for the Dallas Stars. Four shots.
That's crazy.
Combined. Easiest question of the night, reader. Did the Stars shoot enough? Why didn't they shoot enough?
Well, in the second period, I'm not sure they even got out of their own zone half the time. But a lot of the opportunities that they had as we're watching, they were looking to make plays. They've got great skilled players. And when you've got Haskin and you've got Klingberg on the back end, they're looking for the lateral pass. Say again, Ben, they love and Radulov, they love the lateral pass. But there are times, and they started to do it in the overtime periods, where they're down in the corner, they're coming out there of the corner, they're wrapping it up, and they're just shooting it to the net. But to me, they weren't doing it early enough in the game in the second and third period. In the second period, they didn't have a lot of zone time to even do that. But they still denied themselves the opportunity to get second and third opportunities because of the lateral passes. And I'm sure Coach Montgomery was like, guys, let's shoot the puck. We've got to score a goal. We've got to shoot the puck. And they started to do it in overtime. But those numbers in the second and third period give St. Louis all sorts of credit for the way they defended and the way they forechecked. But for the Dallas Stars, there's a lot of talent on that team to get four shots in two periods.
Yeah, there's tons of, I just feel like they left shots on the table. The Dallas Stars did. I mean, they left shots on the table. You see where they rank in terms of fewest shots in a single period of Game 7s. Reader, we were talking about that one with the Sens on the far right with the Ottawa Senators in 0-2. We were talking about that. And yeah, that was just a completely different story. The Leafs.
It stands out when that happens.
It does.
I mean, it's one shot.
It does.
It's crazy to think because there are times when you're in the zone, it's like somebody.
Anybody, just shoot. But I think over time, the wound's still fresh, and understandably so. These two teams played so hard, Game 7. But if you're the Dallas Stars, I'm sure guys are in that locker room right now and saying, guys, we're proud of each other, but we left shots on the table.
Yeah, they did.
We left shots on the table. And that's one of the things. You hear guys in the locker, same thing. Guys in the room, somebody's going to be a hero tonight.
Yep.
So got to shoot it. Who wants to be the hero in the room? Somebody's got to shoot it. And they left shots on the table. I'm sure that's the one element of this game that'll sting for them.